Welcome back, students. Today we are going to study the grammar topic, change the voice. Now, what is change the voice? Change the voice is an expression. There are two ways to it. The voice of a verb tells whether the subject is performer or the receiver of the action. That is active voice and passive voice. What is an active voice? In active voice, the subject performs the action expressed by the verb. The doer, the actor, that is the subject, plus verb plus object of the action is an active voice. For example, he eats mangoes. Now here he does the action of eating. The doer of the action is he. That means it is active voice. It is an active subject. So this is an example of active voice. What is a passive voice? In passive voice, the subject receives the action expressed by the verb. So passive voice means it is the object of action plus verb plus by. For example, mangoes are eaten by him. Now here object becomes subject. Let's have a look at the rules for changing active voice to passive voice. The first rule is to interchange the subject and object. The second rule is take suitable auxiliary according to the tense. The third rule is write the subject of given sentence after by. Slide 7. Rules for changing active voice to passive voice. If the subject is pronoun, change it to passive sentence as follows. I becomes me, we becomes us, you remains you, he becomes him, she becomes her, and they becomes them. Remember to use the word by while changing from active to passive voice. Slide 8. Place the articles prepositions near to noun. For example, the boy looked at the bird. It is active voice. Now passive voice, the answer will be a bird was looked at by the boy. In passive sentence, a preposition by is used before the subject. For example, I call him. The answer will be, he is called by me. Now here, by is used before me. While changing the active to passive voice, we should have a look at the tense and auxiliary verb agreement. Simple present tense, the auxiliary verb will be am, is, are. In simple past tense, the auxiliary verb will be was, were. Simple future tense, the auxiliary verb will be shall be. Present continuous tense, am, is, are plus being. In past continuous tense, we use was, were plus being. In present perfect tense, we use have, has plus been. In past perfect tense, we use had plus been. Future perfect tense, we use will have, shall have plus been. And modal auxiliary, we use modal auxiliary plus be. There are some sentences as imperative sentences which we use the form let. For example, attack the enemy. The passive voice will be let the enemy be attacked. Second example, kill him. The answer is, let him be killed. Salute the flag. The answer is, let the flag be saluted. The fourth one, open the door. The answer is, let the door be opened. Fifth example, close the window. So my passive voice answer is, let the window be closed. The example of interrogative sentences. For question of who, write by whom in passive question. For example, who killed the snake? My answer is, by whom was the snake killed? Second example, who carried the box? Answer is, by whom is the box carried? Third question, where did you keep my pen? Answer is, where was my pen kept by you? Let's have a look at the exercise. The first one is, Harry ate 6 shrimp at dinner. The answer is, at dinner, 6 shrimp were eaten by Harry. Second question, beautiful giraffes roam the savannah. The answer is, the savannah is roamed by beautiful giraffes. Third one, Sue changed the flat tire. The answer is, the flat tire was changed by Sue. The fourth question is, we are going to watch a movie tonight. The answer is, a movie is going to be watched by us tonight. Number fifth, I ran the obstacle course in record time. The answer in passive voice is, the obstacle course was run by me in record time. So here we end this topic of active and passive voice. I request all the students to make a note in their long book the given question and answers of this exercise. Thank you.